Six candidates are vying for the Dokoloman Member of Parliament seat. They include UPC flag bearer Sarah Aguti Nyankori, NRM's Janet Adong Alao, FDC's Dr. Rosemary Aroch Ogwal, and NUP's Harriet Ageno. The independent candidates are Dr. Esther Akolo Obot and Rebecca Arau. Voting materials arrived in most polling stations by 6:30 a.m. and vote casting began by 8 a.m.
Expecting to be the winner, I'll give thanks to my people of Dokolo. Seen anything wrong? We have not been moving at night, so that one I can't say much.
They did a lot more than a member of parliament does, and I would be hoping to do the exact same thing. I am the only candidate that has made a commitment to make significant inward investment in the development of Dokolo and of Lao as a region and of Uganda as well.
As voting continues, most of the polling stations visited by a reporter had recorded a high turnout.
One thing is that people are voting, although the turnout has been low in the morning, but people are coming up to vote. Apparently, as observers, we have not witnessed something which is horrible or terrible. Our consistency is that everything is going on peaceful, and to us, that is very important.
Meanwhile, police in Dokolo Central Police Station are holding in custody the Oyam District One Member of Parliament and two others over vote bribery. Santa Alumo Gwang and the two others yet to be identified were arrested on Monday and whisked to Oyam Central Police Station, where they are currently being detained. Jimmy Patrick Okema, the North Chuga Regional Police spokesperson, confirmed the arrest. Okema said the trio were picked up by police following a tip-off from some members of the public.
So this afternoon, we received communication from members of the public and other people on the ground on suspicion that a member of parliament of Uyam district with others, they have money and are giving out pretexts of asking the community to go and vote in favor of their candidates. It is within our responsibilities to verify this information. Our team went on ground. Indeed, we have picked the woman member of parliament together with our two colleagues.
By press time, the legislature and two other suspects were recording statements at the police station.
There's more to come, more to unfold, but this is not something which we are going to take lying down. We have fought hard for this election, and despite whatever the malpractices they have tried to put in place, we are confident of a victory.
As I speak now, the matter is being investigated to understand the circumstances of the allegation. Allegation will always remain an allegation. So, not until someone is proved with evidence, enough evidence, and that's it. If you have found out there is nothing, definitely they will be given 18 and set free in line to what the procedure says.
Report compiled by Solomon Okabo for the news.